Today, I'm going to answer the question, how can I use Power Automate to send attachments to SharePoint when an email is put in a specific Outlook folder? In this scenario, I'm assuming that you don't want all email attachments to go to SharePoint, only some of them. I have navigated to Power Automate and I'm going to go to the Create page. This is going to be an automated cloud flow. The first thing I want to do is give my flow a name, otherwise Power Automate will assign it a generic one. Now I need to search for my trigger, which is going to be when an email arrives V3. Notice that this says we are using an Office 365 trigger. This is the one to choose when using an Outlook account tied to a business subscription, such as a work email. Then click on Create. The default is to trigger anytime an email arrives in your inbox. However, I want to tie this to a folder instead. So I will need to click on the folder icon on the right-hand side of the trigger card. And now you can see all of the folders that are available. In this example, I want to use Power Automate Demo. Now this flow will only trigger when a new email is added to the folder. It does not matter if you set up a rule to route it to the folder or you drag and drop the email. Next, we will tell Power Automate what to do when the email gets to the folder. Click New Step to add an action. Search for Outlook. And then select Office 365 Outlook Connector. And then I'm going to look for the action Get Attachments. The message ID is a mandatory field, and we're going to use dynamic content to get that information from the trigger when a new email arrives. And this is the unique identifier for the specific message. Now I want to get attachment ID, and it's also going to be pulled from the when a new email arrives trigger. Power Automate will automatically add and apply to each loop because there may be more than one attachment. Now that we've identified the message ID and the attachment ID, we have to tell Power Automate what to do with it. So we're going to add an action within the apply to each loop. Based on the given scenario, we want to move this attachment to SharePoint. So I'm searching for the SharePoint connector, and then I'm going to narrow it down by create a file. For this action, we need to designate a site address. The dropdown will show you a list of sites you use often. I will select my information hub. Then I need to choose a folder path. Here you see a list of folders that I have available on that SharePoint site, and I'm going to drill down into the training materials by clicking on this arrow. Now I can see my Power Automate folder, so I will select it to add it to the folder path field. Next, you're going to need to grab the file name, and this is going to be pulled in using dynamic content from the previous steps. Now, there's a lot of things here to search through, so I'm going to use the search field to narrow it down to just attachments. Once I do that, you can see that we have the when a new email arrives V3, and then there is the choice for attachment name. Now we need to tell Power Automate to grab the file content. So look inside the attachment as well and bring me all of the details. Now you see that there are two choices here. There's the attachment content from when a new email arrives V3 and the content bytes from get attachment V2. We want to grab the content bytes so that we get all of the information that's necessary. The flow is complete, but as a tip, I always suggest that you test your flow. For example, the first time I created this flow, I used attachment content and received an error. So to trigger the flow, I have already written an email, and I'm just going to send it to myself. Once it arrives in my inbox, I'm going to drag and drop that down to the Power Automate folder. Remember, this flow is not going to trigger when it lands in your inbox. It's only going to trigger when it gets to the folder. So let's jump on over to SharePoint, and you can see that I am in the M365 Training Materials document library in the Power Automate folder. Once I hit F5, you will see that the flow was successful, and I now have the attachment in this folder that came from the original email. So there you go. Now you can use Power Automate to save time moving files from Outlook to SharePoint manually. If you want to learn more about Power Automate, check out the video here on the screen. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.